The Wood Whisperer is sponsored by FESTOOL, faster, easier, smarter, and by POWERMATIC, the gold standard since 1921.
The next thing we need to do is create a rabbet all the way around this frame to hold the top panel. The top panel actually is, a frame of panel assembly, but it sits down in a rabbet made into these components. I'll edit this one. I can just double-click to get into it, into editing mode. You'll see that if I select something in there, like this line, the mirror version is selected in this component across the way. So any component I edit will update all other copies of that same component, which is the strength of components. Using the pencil tool, I can actually just extend the line from there to there, and then the push tool, I'll spin around here so you can see what's happening. I want a rabbet. You can see it's modifying both sides at the same time. I want a rabbet that's 3/4 of an inch deep, so I'll just type in 3/4, and then I can click outside the component that I'm currently editing outside these dotted lines to close it, or I can right click and close, whichever one works best for you. So now I have most of a rabbet all the way around. I'll go ahead and edit these as well. So I want a rabbet. This one's a little more difficult because there's no line to identify where the quarter inch mark is. I want to save this quarter inch lip outside. I'll use the ruler tool, grab that edge, and if you just click it on an edge and pull away, type in 1/4 inch, it creates a layout line. So now I can use the pencil tool, the line tool, and those intersections, those points are well defined. So I can go from one end to the other, and again with the push tool, push it down, and I can reference this face over here. I don't have to type the dimension in this time. Click outside the component to close it, and now we have a rabbet all the way around the entire thing. There are a couple little lines here I'll clean up just to be a perfectionist, and there we are. That's our completed frame. Well, it looks like I spoke a little too soon. There is a little bit of cleanup that I still need to do here. The layout lines that are in here, let's go ahead and delete those real quick. And then if I pull one of the components using the move tool and the control key over to the side and rotate up underneath it, you'll see that the bottom face, if I can get over there, the bottom face is actually missing. It's hollow. We don't want that. We definitely want to just double click in here, use the line tool to trace over one of the existing lines, and that face will heal itself. Again, it's fixing itself and all the rest of the components as well, so that's good. There is, I believe, there's this little stray line here. I can just delete that component because I don't need it. I fixed the other ones. And I've probably got the same thing going on over here with the other component. Let me just double check. Move it off to the side. Get down there, look at the bottom of it, it's hollow. So let's fix that as well. Double click, line tool, any line on that face will fix itself. We can then click away outside the component and then actually just delete it because the other two are fixed. So okay, so that is what I'm going to call a completed frame assembly. Next we'll get started on the frame and panel assembly for the top of the trunk. If you think about it, it's like having a cabinet door that's really just set into this rabbet. What I'll do is remind you that this is 2 inches tall. So what we'd like is for the outer frame, the outer perimeter, to look like it's 2 inches tall. But we have this 1/4 inch lip that's left from the rabbet. So if I take the ruler tool and come up with this edge, I'll come straight across, if I can get straight across, and wait till it's red there. And I'll come 1 3/4 inch, which will be a total dimension of 2 inches to the edge. Then I'll use the rectangle tool to come from that corner there to this corner down here. That is going to be one of the end rails. I'll use the push-pull tool, pull it down till it's even with that face, that edge. And now basically it's 1 3/4 by 3/4 of an inch. But again, this total dimension to the outside is 2 inches. I'm I'm going to make that one of my components. I can just actually triple click it, and it selects everything that's just been drawn there. I will actually get rid of the layout line first, triple click, right click, make it a component, and I will call that one a top rail. I think it's a rail. I always get rails and styles messed up. And before we leave this component, I'm going to work on some of the joinery for it, moving a copy off to the side again, rotating so that we can see the end, entering into the component so that we can edit it. I'll use the ruler tool to come down a quarter inch from the top, up a quarter inch from the bottom, and actually in 3/8 of an inch from the side. So that's the layout for our rabbit. Use the rectangle tool then to get it there, and the push tool, I'm going to actually just push it all the way to the end. And now that is the rabbit that is going to hold the panels and actually the styles, I guess, that will fit into it as well. Again, since I've edited that component, the one over here in my main model has been updated as well. I'll use the copy actually on the other side though. Let's just go ahead and move it from there. Just move it over here closer, get in a little closer, rotate it using the little plus signs there, and then move it to where it belongs. There we go. Now we got a right and a left, a top and a bottom, whatever you want to call it, but we got two components in there that are all the joinery is done. Next we'll work on some of the front rails, front and the back rails. They will be same old tricks, ruler tool, 1 3/4 of an inch. I want to make sure I'm on the green axis before I do that. 1 3/4 of an inch. Rectangle tool from that intersection we just created over to this corner. Push tool, bring it down to there, 3/4 of an inch. Triple click, get rid of the layout line. Triple click, make it a component. Front rail. I think my terminology has been pretty messed up here, but hopefully you guys are understanding what I'm doing, if not what I'm saying. Same old trick, bring it off to the side. Let's do some joinery, create a dado, not a rabbit as I called it earlier. I'm going to do it a little differently this time. I'm going to go in here and just draw a rectangle. And if I look down here in the bottom, I'm always trying to figure out which dimension is first, but the larger dimension looks like it's second. So I'm going to come in, let's see, 1/4, 3/8, I believe, should work. There we go. The only problem is it's not centered, but I can select that rectangle and the move tool, find the midpoint and move it up and down. When you're moving something, you can once you get on an axis and it tells you you're on an axis, you can hold down the shift key, and then no matter what you do with the mouse, it always stays on that axis. So I've got it by I'm holding it by the midpoint, if you will, and I'm going to move it to that midpoint, so now I know it's centered. Then the push tool will bring it all the way through, creating a dado or a groove that's going to hold the panels. The only other thing we need to do is we need a little bit of a tenon or a tongue on it. So let's rough that in real quick. Out 3/8 of an inch, same depth as the groove in the other piece. We actually need to do that to the far end as well, because there will be a mirroring groove down at that end. There, right there, and push out 3/8 of an inch. All right, there we go. Again, I'm going to use this copy, rotate it 180 degrees, and put it into position where magically it fits right into the groove that I have established. Boy, I'm probably making you guys dizzy with all my spinning around, but you can see what the joint's going to look like there.
This is just one part of a three-part series on SketchUp Basics. but if you've never used the program before, you might need a more in-depth introduction. For that, I recommend going to SketchUpForWoodworkers.com. Rob will take you through the basics of setting up a project from a woodworker's perspective, so I highly recommend checking his site out. Thanks for watching, everybody.